to set up a shot. It didn't get through. Buffalo coming back 2-on-1.
Duncan Keith, who was on that rush and was knocked down, had a heck of a time getting up.
And now.
It's 0-0 in the game, but it's 1-0 in terms of big hits for Detroit. And Alex Tanguay gets this pass. He puts his head down just for an instant, and you see how quick things happen. Brad Stewart steps up on him, Chris, and lets him have it. Just put his head down a little bit before that, but bam, to the ice, and that leaves a mark.
Does it ever? Brad Stewart leading.
Weiss was denied by Fleury.
Good speed by Steven Weiss.
Malkin. Oh, Keith Ballard lined him up and upended him. And now Crosby going after Ballard. And
well, it's got to be, Denny, early on, our checkers check of the game. Ballard lining up Malkin. Checkers, little place, big taste.
It looked like Malkin never saw.
That's a F-L-U-R-R-Y, Fleury. All right. The Keith Ballard play here, Bill. I mean, when you look at this play, it's something they've talked about at the NHL meetings. I think they got to make the penalty even worse because Ballard makes a great check on Malkin. You know, Penguins will say good credit to Crosby for jumping in. Your thoughts?
No, that is a beautiful hip check. Oh. Malkin goes bum over tea kettle, and then Ballard dropped his gloves right away. That's what I love best. He knew he was going to have to answer. I'm not sure if Crosby thought he had to fight him, but he bumped in, said, I got to go, and then Crosby gets the worst of this punishment as Ballard is able to finally get that left free, throws loose, but a couple bombs right off.
Turning back Bork. Here's Rene Bork dashing in. Trying to get around Janssen. In behind the goal. Cowboy. Huge hit. Bugard leveling Bork with an enormous hit. In St. Paul.
Mike Keenan. Mike Keenan is hot. Yelling at Dan O'Halloran here as a result of this hit. The puck is nowhere near Rene Bork.
Rusty Kessler defending, rolls it along and up on the left wing. RJ Umber, oh my, blindsided there.
Oh, that was Stewart. Boy, Umberger, he's down. I'll tell you, he did not see that, partner.
He was blindsided.
Down.
Absolutely, and Umberger still in a heap of trouble.
Oh, yeah, I mean, Stewart caught him coming in and right down low with that hip. Remind me a little bit of the hit that Umberger took years ago by Brian Campbell in Buffalo in the playoffs. But Umberger just, he gets his positioning, the heads up, tries to move it, but the player, Stewart, just keeps coming in, and cranks him.
He was looking for that puck up along the wall, and at the last moment, Danny, you're right, he just saw him coming there. But RJ, he's one tough customer.
Well, I know, anytime you're hitting the shoulder or even the head area, this is something that takes time to get the old legs going, but whoa, boy, that's a tough one there. The legs say, or the mind says legs move, the legs say not yet. But RJ's a tough competitor, as you mentioned.
Play David Krejci going into the corner, but oh, there goes a pane of glass on a gigantic Lucic hit. Mike Van Ryn on the receiving end of that, and that'll make every highlight reel for about a decade.
Second huge hit in this hockey game tonight, delivered by the Boston Bruins. Period number one, it was Dennis Wiedemann on Matt Stage, and now Milan Lucic on Mike Van Rijn. Van Rijn trying to handle that puck along the boards, and you can see him, Jack. He's bracing for the hit. He knows it's coming. He moves the puck. He knows he has to pay a price to get this puck out of his own zone. He braces for the hit, but sometimes it doesn't matter. And you need to stay within the rules. And Lucic elbows down, stick up in the air a little bit, but there was no contact with his stick with Van Rijn.
It's manufactured.
Can you say that three times fast?
No. I could barely say it once.
Sharp, spiky shards.
Right. There it is. Kerblam.
Leason steps into Campoli. Wallin, the defenseman, back pressuring. And it's Leason unable to spin it the other way. It goes off of Ward's stick. Then Ward got tangled up with Campoli as well as Leason. And here's Sutter. Bumped hard and hurt, apparently, by Waite. Oh, did Waite lean into it? And two Hurricanes.
Just a clean shoulder check. Sutter touches the puck.
Yeah, the arm's down.
And the arm is down, and the shoulder is down. And you know what? You'll see this again, and look how vulnerable he leaves himself. Shoulder head down, shoulder of Doug Waite stays in as well. It's a clean hit. This will be normal speed the next replay we show you, folks. Listen in. It's a clean hit. Knew it was clean. He backed up, and watch as he was ready for somebody to come at him. Now, here's the clean hit. Again, kid's down. Now, Doug Waite's going to pick his head up, and look, he looks over at him, and you don't see in this shot right here, but he starts backing up, waiting for somebody to come at him. Because it's a clean hit, you say, you know, what you're saying to yourself is you never want to hurt anybody, but you know that you did what was fair, what was right, and what was justified. Because you know what? I guarantee you Doug Waite has been thumped like, similar to that before. Whether he went down and stayed down, I can't speak up. I can't speak to that 100%. But he did his job there, Howie, and there was nothing malicious about it. He went in body check. Clean way.
And I think the Hurricane players, even though.
I wonder why. Since he doesn't watch the show, pitched around behind by Zetterberg. Taken off now by Franzen. Fed one for Zetterberg. Crossed off though. Here's Stewart a shot, and that one went off Leno's stick and wide. Oh! Man! He's out. And then an extra hit came from Bufflin, and a crowd gathers. Bufflin got Cronwall.
I mean, you're talking about big hits. This is as big as it gets. I mean, the puck. Puck was coming up the right wing. Other side of the rink. Right part of your screen. There's the puck. Hamlet never touched it. The puck was right under him. Yeah. He thought it was coming to his stick, Doc, and it hit something on the boards and then went right between his legs. Watch. It goes right between his skates. He looked down to find it, and you look down, and somebody's coming to look you, to knock you in the next week. And not only the hit, Doc, the jarring, but also, too, once he, now you got everybody coming in, no regard for Marty Havlat, everybody trying to come in, but it was the hit, and he got jarred, and then he fell back, Doc, and it looked like the shoulder, the back, and then the head on the ice.
He's able to sit and chat with one of the team physicians.